me, interrimo ad appare dorime. Ameno, ameno, lanciremo dorime. Ameno, o manare impera via, ameno. Timere, timere, manciro, manciremo, ameno.
Yo, what's up, Donkey? Helios fly today? You know. How is everybody doing today? Hey, Violet! It was a good break. Oh, no. Yo, what's up, Zappy? Why the special guest? Yep. I'm excited. Me and Ayo actually thought of some topics that are actually good topics. And then Firestaff couldn't come on.
Bang the bang, diggy diggy.
You've been really sad the past few days? Yo, me too.
The bang, diggy diggy. Drop the boogie. Oh, the bang.
I still gotta upload the last podcast. Cause I never did that. Where's Devin Nash? I'm not getting Devin Nash on. This is easy, bro. That's a Rocky. A Ducky. A Donkey. Ayo. Pokey Day for the Raids. Red Bull Pug. So scary. What's up, Zappy? What's up, Face Bobs? What's up, Violet? Okay. The bot we see. Got a retirement for the stream, don't piss you off. I think we will. Okay, bye the senior. Oily, join the link I sent you. Are you still talking? Just shut up. The Minecraft server I was playing on got shut down. What? Oh no. You haven't been talking to any IRL friends? Oh. With the bang, the bang, the bang, diggy, diggy. JK, LOL. Fucking go, man. The stream will cease your sadness. No, it won't. And now drop the boogie. Ball with. Oh. Violet, change your name. Change it to just like Violet. I already changed my name, speaking of that. Rename. I changed it for my college advising meeting. I got my schedule done. Yeah, are you proud? I'm going into retirement. Yeah. Schedule? What's that, bro? College schedule? I am not, and I don't plan on it. Drop the boogie ball with the... Wait, no, I'm top right. You can't do Pepe Laugh top right. You can't do that. Hey, dig it, dig it. Wait, AO's gonna be bottom left, so get your copy passes ready. AO's already. I literally cannot change it. I cannot change it on. Oh. Okay, I'll just do this. Ah, these glasses suck. I wonder if I have any more. Get your top or bottom left copy passes ready. Oh, no, no, no. That's because Jaren can't be on it. Yeah, that's why AO's not top right. That's why I'm top right. So we got some pretty good topics lined up. We got some pretty good. We don't have guests. Firestaff wasn't able to make it. Pretty sad, but it's okay. Don't need him, right? Front middle. We got four people on here. Easy Rod. Which one is Violet in? I'm not telling you. Wait, she's deafened. Wait, change your profile picture. So that it shows the profile picture. What? The good thing? We have a female on Easy Run. Oh, real. Six more for Raj Royale. True. Any six people want to get on here? Just have to end the donkey. Okay. Do I look big? Am I swole? Yeah, I already know. You bought a webcam? Really? You guys, if you got a cam, you can come on. Cause I only want to have like one non-cam. And Violet doesn't have a camera. What? Okay, dude. This is me, actually. That's actually me. Dude, you can do? Alright. Rocket does have a cam, true. A special appearance later. Okay, dude. I should get a pump going, right? Leggy doesn't have a sub in train chat. Oh. There's another easy rod in it. Oh. What? Okay. Is Violet ready? He's still deafened. Oh, I went. You can't just be deafened in Discord. I can't stall for too long. I can't stall for 4 hours again. I'm not gonna do that. I'm stuck in a tree, dude. What the fuck? Game's glitching. Fix your game. Oh no. Where's Violet? Y'all both gotta have webcams on. What's up, MCJ? Hoki's busy. Oh my god, they're expecting me to stall for like an hour, dude. We can do it. Slash daily dose. Yo, nice. Nice shot. Yo, Bob. Oh, we've already seen it. We've already seen this Daily Dose. What? Hey, everyone, it should... How much is a ski mask? I don't know. Buy one right now. Yo, what's up, Leggy? Wait. Where's Leggy? He's not in here.
That's the shit I don't like.
A snitch. I really... Oh, she just muted. Boy, are you back? Hoki, are you ready?
Whoa.
Hello.
Oh.
I will turn your cams on. If you wanna get on, I don't know who I could give the link to. It's not in here. Oh. Okay, I got a full screen it. It will turn your cam on, man. He hasn't talked on stream lately. Can you see if your cam works? Oh! Then I'll be too echoey.
He hasn't talked on stream lately.
Who's the echo?
Oh, she's listening. She's watching me. I can hear myself twice. Oh!
Oh, this hurts.
That's my... I fixed it. That's my stupid mic, and I didn't have noise suppression on, so...
Oh! Hey, where's your cam?
Ayo.
So, gentlemen, Ayo moved his setup again from where you just saw him on stream.
Facts.
Cool. I gotta do this.
Co-host gotta do what he gotta do. You feel me?
Bam. And then I could do this.
True.
Top right, Busta. Oh no.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Wait. I don't even know.
I get bottom right.
Bottom right.
Or bottom left.
Top right. Bottom okay. Easy, bro. I'm going to turn off push to talk.
Yo, let's make it 4 hours tonight.
4 hours? 4 hour podcast? 4 hours, 4 hours, one for each marathon. Person.
Yo, we'll Koki, see, I'll carry you through. Man. I'll carry you on my back if I have to.
Ayo got heated earlier? Yeah, I know.
For what?
Of Dark Souls, weren't you playing Dark Souls?
Oh yeah, I rage quit. Yeah, I suck.
Alright, boys. Today, on the Yepcast, over this way is Koki's nose. This way is Bottom left, Busta. Ayo. Down here.
Ayo, army, rise up.
He's a female. Oh.
Oh, no.
Yeah, Scary got suspended. Speaking of Scary getting suspended, how do you feel about it since Alinity showed Nip and she got one day after she said that she should get banned, and then Scary just got a 3-day suspension?
Pretty fucked.
Do we know actually what he
sexual
did,
content
or no?
It's just his body painting.
Do we got any clips? Any clips to bring up?
Any clippers?
We cannot watch clips of him if he's not on the platform.
We really can't even mention his name, so.
Well, yeah, we can.
Isn't it like you're not supposed to talk?
No.
About...
He just can't be on the stream.
Are we allowed to mention what happened last night with him?
No. I already deleted the mod.
Yeah, delete the mod. Mod's gone. Okay.
I'm pretty sure it's because he painted nipples. Well, it's because. He, you know. Hey, yo, you want to start it off?
Painted nipples.
What do I want to do?
What?
Nothing sexual related to male nipples. Like, you can't do any sexual, like, related things or whatever. But that's still stupid.
Yeah, all he did was body paint, which females are able to do and get away with. But, you know.
Was, like, the outline of his dick showing or what?
No.
Well, that's art, isn't it?
Okay, it might be something else. He twerked.
Dude, I twerk on my stream almost every day.
That's true. The first stream I ever watched of you, you danced for like 10
and
minutes.
That's why you come back every day.
Yeah, no.
Yeah,
that's
you can't twerk on stream no matter what gender you are.
That's ridiculous. Like,
yeah, that's crazy.
If they're not showing anything and they're just like dancing around or whatever, like, just let them do whatever they're doing. Man or woman, you know, like.
No.
Shameless. Holy fuck, can we get legs a 5 minute or something? Jesus Christ, dude.
Bottom left.
God
legs
damn,
is a good
it
guy.
Is just unreal, dude.
Legs is a good guy.
Damn, Chad just really doesn't like you, eh?
Nah, they hate me. Hey. Most hated on. If they hate, then watch them hate and watch the money pile up, son. That's all I gotta say. Hey.
Ayo army, baby.
Ayo army, raise up.
That's right.
Any Ayo frogs? Why are you being so toxic?
I just said that to piss them off even more, dude.
Top left, white people happy, yes. Ayo, spit out a topic.
Yeah.
Now.
Bet. So me and Koki were actually talking about Diablo 2. Because XQC and Trainwrex and Moxie are about to do a playthrough of it. And that kind of got us talking last night. We were chilling and we were talking about, I think it was on Koki's stream, we were talking about just remasters in general. So oftentimes, so many times, honestly, I find it so hard for remasters to be even close to the original. You know what I mean? I think it's so difficult to do remasters that basically Diablo 2 was rumored to be a remake coming from the Destiny 2 studios, and it was supposed to be coming out soon this year. But you know, I also think that, I mean, if you look at a lot of the top streamers these days, a lot of people are going back to the classics. I know Mizkiff and Mitch Jones are going back playing Super Mario 64. You know, these big streamers going back to Diablo 2.
Good clips and shit coming out of that.
Oh, yeah.
Really good.
True. I mean, Mizkiff is one of his highest viewer counts that I've seen in a long time. So props to him. But I think that it's just like, is the scene just dry? Or I think that good graphics doesn't necessarily make a good game. And I think in that time, when everybody had 8-bit graphics, it relied more on mechanics that made a game great, right? I don't know.
Yeah,
that's just my
take. Sure. That's what I think, too, is that people are going back to games that are notorious for good mechanics and good, not necessarily story, but like a good way to follow, a good way to level up, just a great game. Diablo 2 is amazing, man. And what you were talking about with remastered, like, the remasters are, it's like one in a million that it's going to be good, you know? They make a good one, and then they make a shit one. The most recent one from Blizzard, the same company that owns Diablo 2, was Warcraft 3, and that was a really shitty remaster, man. They really fucked it up. But we'll see with this Diablo 2 remaster if it comes out and it's good or not. To be honest, I'm fine playing the old Diablo 2. It's pretty good.
I just
did go ahead.
I just think like the game market right now, like new games, is pretty fucking stale. It's just a bunch of BRs, you know, shooter games, you know, there's none of the classic style games and MMOs and shit releasing now that are have piqued my interest, and I know a lot of other people feel the same way, you know. It's just the same recycled content. Man.
It's all the same shit. And then the only reason I play a new game is to play with the homies. Like, if my friends are playing it, I'll go play with them. If it's cheap, it's like $20 to get the game.
Yeah, true. Violet, what's your take?
I haven't been playing video games for a really long time. The games that I play right now are mostly just the games that I like. Have been introduced to by people that I've met, like you guys, like with Stardew and stuff. And with Minecraft, I played like Pocket Edition when I was little, but I didn't play like the full version ever. And so I don't have a lot to say on the new games that are coming out right now, but.
Gary Skellens brings up a good point. The remasters are hard for the companies who make them. Because of the nostalgia based, and you know, it's hard to live up to like if like Black Ops 2 got remastered, but it probably won't. It'll be hard to live up to that because Black Ops 2 is a really, really nostalgic game, you know, and it was a really good game. It'll be hard for them to remaster that.
Do you guys think? I think Black Ops 1 remaster is probably the next one that's going to come out. I mean, the zombies will probably be nice, but. I mean, have you guys played any of the Call of Duty remasters? Because
no,
I mean,
no, I haven't checked them out. No.
I think Warzone definitely pushed it a little too far for trying to be like modern. Like they added Rust, right? I mean, I feel like that was just like a desperation heave at trying to get people to feel nostalgic and stuff. I think there is a didn't Modern Warfare 2 remaster just come out or something like that? I don't know, but
I think it's coming out. Yeah, I saw it on the Blizzard launcher like a month ago.
Yeah, but you know, also on this topic, I think that games today are just pushing the higher graphics, higher CPU requirements, and like, you know, you gotta think, right? I mean, who's sponsoring these game dev companies, right? This might be too five head for you guys in chat, but however, who do you think is sponsoring these game dev companies, right? What if it's Intel and what if it's Nvidia who want to make money with increasing the limits of their game, which require stronger PCs, stronger parts for their PCs, and they're sponsored by these companies that make the graphic cards, make the processors, all that, right? You got to think, and that's the whole system.
For sure. I think that's a good point, but for me, like, video games recently, like, the past 4 years, I haven't really seen too big of, like, a graphics uphaul. Maybe there has been, but I usually just play games on like lower settings, you know.
Same.
But
I mean, that's
a really good point, though.
I mean, it's got to have an effect, right? Because I mean, if you look at the Assassin's Creed, right, all the new Assassin's Creed games coming out, there you got to have a fucking $8,000 fucking tower, fucking triple core, liquid cooled, fucking wires every six console, right? Like, you got to have such a setup in order to play this that you gotta think there's just, it's money. It's gotta be money, right? Because at the end of the day, do you think gamers really care about the graphics? No. I think they care about mechanics, because I was just replaying Donkey Kong Country on the SNES and I got it on my computer on an emulator. White Hardo, I had the original game, but and like the mechanics are so good. When you jump, it jumps. When you like use an item, it uses it right on time. It's completely reactive, right? Now, a lot of these other games, it just lacks that. And it lacks
you pressing space to jump and using an item.
Exactly.
How does it lack that?
They make up for it with high graphics. I just don't get it, man. I just don't get it. I feel like they're in the wrong direction.
Wait, the mechanics are like, the mechanics you see in video games today have been around for so long, and they're just like rehashing it with new graphics. I think that's what AO is trying to get at a bit. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, I just feel like a lot of the games, when the graphics were just standard and there wasn't much for them to improve, that it enforced innovation in the creativity and mechanics and actual story and actual content.
Well,
true, man.
The thing with battle royales is that they don't need story. They don't really need content. It's just the same copy-pasted shooter over and over and over again. That's what made Fortnite stick out. Like, bad game. But, you know, when it came out, the mechanic was new to, like, battle royales. Like, they had building in Minecraft, of course, but, you know, they added building to battle royale that added a whole new mechanic. And, like, there's been no other battle royales that have tried experimenting with that, with, like, a new mechanic in a game. So, like,
well, Realm Royale had, like, the horses, right? You had, like, something you could ride, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. But it was a flop. Incredibly.
Says Warcraft, what other remasters have flopped? I've never played remasters.
So, also, that also expands to, I mean, like, the same thing goes for, like, movie sequels, right? Like, you almost feel like it's forced, and it's just, like, they ran out of content. So they're just, like, trying to get that original success they had, and they just, you know, they hire some rookie fucking dev team. Not the original dev team that made the game great. And then it's just, and then they just, you know, they commercialize it, they promote the shit out of it. And at the end of the day, it's a shit game, and I can't stand it anymore.
Man,
like Valorant.
First time I saw that was with Bungie and 343
Halo.
Dude, yeah, man.
It was absolute shit.
And 343 took over and fucked it all up, and just, it was stupid, man. And it wasn't really a remaster, it was kind of like a takeover and a resell of the games. They did Master Chief Collection, and it was just all the same games, but then the program itself, it was just shit. Like, you couldn't even find matches. Mm-hmm. Like, it was fucked, man.
I just got the Halo, what is it, Master Chief Collection? That's what it is, right? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I got that and I tried it, and, like, you know, first off, I thought it was guaranteed that you would get every game. So, of course not. You know, they released it with only, I don't know which one they released first. I think it was Halo Reach. Yeah, Halo Reach was the first one that you could only play that one, right? And then, like, you're just waiting and waiting.
Yeah, they're releasing them one by one. Like,
yeah,
it's so
I don't
hard
get
for
that,
them
man.
To do that. Like,
I don't know. And the mechanics transferred over. Like, a lot of games, there's other games where the mechanics from controller to PC actually go really well. Like, I feel like the COD games usually do a good job, but the transfer of Halo from to PC, the controls felt really weird. It did not feel right.
Really? Okay. Oh, yeah, I haven't got to check it out on PC yet. I've been
holding off. That's an amazing point, the Halo Bungie to 343. That's like, exactly my argument. Yep.
The last Halo I played was Halo Reach on the 360. I haven't played any Halo since. And that was like 7 years ago. So
I bought the 343 ones, Halo 4 and Halo 5, and then I was super disappointed and just sold my Xbox One and never looked back.
I haven't touched an Xbox One since I got my PC in 2017.
Word, brother.
I've only played Halo Reach once, I think. And it was a long time ago. I don't even remember that much the gameplay.
I used to go over to our friends like almost every day, and all we would do is play Halo.
Yeah, I have like a group of friends, and we all go to, before quarantine, I guess, we used to all go to his house and just play like Smash Bros. And like Call of Duty, Black Ops 3 and stuff. And he's got like a, I can't remember the name of the console, but I will remember it in a second. And yeah, it's a lot of fun.
The days before quarantine.
When I was younger, I'd play a lot of Halo with friends at their house and stuff. Like Halo 1 and 2, we play on the old Xbox.
You know, me and my friends actually didn't mind Halo 4, though. Halo 4, we actually played a good bit. I don't know, I liked it.
Yeah, it was just too different for me from Halo Reach and Halo 3, it definitely
felt good. Yeah, I still feel that the Halo Reach times, though, were real shit.
I loved Halo 3, man. That was probably my favorite. I played a lot of Reach, though. A lot of Reach custom games and shit.
We miss Halo 3 days. Yeah, me too, man. I remember it was the first game I ever got on a console. Way back in the day, man. A lot of
people, yeah, man. I think the first 360 game I got was Ghost Recon. Like, the old first Ghost Recon.
I played that on the PS1.
Graw. Do you remember Ghost Recon Graw for the Xbox 360?
I never played on the 360.
Oh. That was an old game.
But on the Xbox One.
It would ship with your 360. It was the first game everyone got for your 360. It was funny as fuck, man.
Dude, mine was, what came with my Xbox was Skyrim. And I had no idea what the game was. And I ended up playing it, beating the game. And it's my favorite game probably of all time. And I like, what are the chances, dude? It was such a good game. Such a good game. But the 360 days, just legendary. Legendary, man.
Skyrim was the first game I ever played on 360.
Yeah, it was, for me, it was FIFA and Skyrim, because I was a soccer lad.
Oblivion, he's bringing up Oblivion. I played that on the PC when I was a kid.
Ooh.
Not even on 360. I think it came out on 360 first, though, or something like that. Or it come out on PC.
It's called footy, mate. Oh, no.
Dude, I'm literally... Look at the flags, dude. I'm trying to appeal to the normies, okay?
Okay, dude. Okay, so...
Not you. Just Donald Dump Truck.
Duck shit.
Ban shit.
How do you think you'd be able to balance, like, extreme toxicity in a community? And, like, the wholesome frogs. Like, what Train does. How do you think you'd be able to handle that?
I ban anyone who I don't agree with, and that's the end of it.
I like that.
Dude, I like how Kogi just, like, he's past it. He's just like, you know what?
Well, I've been on Twitch for a long time, man. I just give a shit. Like,
you just don't have time for it.
True. That's the best ideology on Twitch, right? Just bring the ban hammer on anybody that says you're wrong.
Well, as you guys can see with fucking Train's chicken legs, one of my frequent community members, clearly you can see that we have over at my stream, we have a good balance. Not, and you know, by good balance, I mean he's literally always toxic, but I think I kind of like it. I like the banter. I love Floor Weird. It's my favorite emote. I love it because I'm the same way. Because if Legs actually had the balls to come up on a podcast and put his face out there, then I would be doing the same shit. So I get it. Okay. However, I think that what Train's doing is a little weird, Squad R. A little weird.
Dude, you know?
A little weird.
He was going off at the start of his show there. Just
I told you. He's starting to just, even if it's like a lol W, dude. No matter what kind of sub he is, he'll just ban it. And I think, you know, I understand the My Man ban, which, you know, My Man's been in my stream.
I love My Man.
No, I love him too. But when he's doing it 24/7 from when Train, like literally in his offline chat, when he starts stream all the way to the end to after, all the way through, spamming Pain's Champ and Four Weird, like I get it. Okay. Like I get it. I understand why he banned him. However, when you literally take the toxic people and tell them to cam up and you start a little mini podcast because you're so out of content that you literally invite random viewers that are toxic onto a mini podcast, I think that's a little much.
True.
I think that's a little much, dude. You're literally encouraging toxicity because these people want their face on your stream. And you're encouraging that. And then he said, one guy is talking shit, spamming multiple paragraphs, adding him, saying, I'll talk shit. Like literally up arrow key, enter. Dude. And then he pulls him on and he says, I don't have a webcam. And then Train buys him a webcam. How fucking backwards is that, dude?
It's insane, man.
Oh my god.
It's because they keep his chat active.
It's for the drama.
Yeah, that's good drama, though. It's good views, good drama. True.
Well, they just give him content.
If I heard that a bunch of hate watchers from the chat are going to be on a little podcast, I'd actually go watch.
Like, it's free content.
Dude, it's free content, but is that...
it's definitely not good content. It's not good content. Like, it's very toxic.
Like, it's one thing coming unprepared, dude. You can go on Google. You can go on any Reddit. Go on r/insanepeoplefacebook. Go on r/fucking... You have a Reddit. You have a Reddit. But you took 7 hours talking about toxic people to get to your Reddit when there's literally people who make content for you. I just don't get it.
It's actually crazy that he's doing that now.
I mean, I don't know. I understand where he's coming from, though. You know, getting all the toxic frogs and, you know, using them for content because they're already the content in chat. Might as well bring them on stream, right?
Yeah, but it also just makes me, like, not anxious, but it just gives me weird vibes. Because you know how easily someone could cam up and just, like, you know, say something, do something?
Yeah, true, yeah.
Like, that's such a liability. But I think he's just
He's looking for chat veterans, though. People who have something to lose when...
dude, he told... When they he was telling 1 month subs to cam up, dude.
Oh,
just
fuck.
Like,
1 month subs?
I just felt really
fuck?
Awkward. I just felt really weird, dude. I was like... Yikes.
I kind of assume that he's looking for like 12-month subs and making sure podcast. They're in a couple other chats too.
The mini podcast he had was mostly like veterans, but
okay, yeah.
Hopefully. But you know, and now those people who got on that mini cast, like Bezraps, who's my homie, like he'll ban and like he'll mass timeout any people spamming four weird, but because Bezraps was on the podcast, like. He'll be saying way worse shit than me, but not get timed out because he has to, because he used them for content. And it just leads to so much shit, man. And then like he starts roasting like people who use four weird, and you look at chat and the only people saying true lol W are like 1 month subs, non subs. Their names are like XX Freak Monster 26. Like, is that really what you want your community to be, dude? No, I don't fucking want that.
But like, it's all the Warzone frogs. So it's
it
all
is.
The people.
It's 100% is.
It'll stay with him when he watches Warzone. Like, he has his just chatting frogs, which are most of the OGs, and then he just has his Warzone frogs. You know. All the just shining frogs leave, and then he just has the people that will just watch Warzone talking to chat. And, you know,
like my man though definitely pushed it a little bit. When you Pain's Champ tea time, you're writing like 8 line paragraphs from start to finish. Like I get it, I would probably do the same. However, like it wasn't that bad until he started really enforcing it, and that just made him go harder. Right, that only made my man go harder. And the thing that
incite
made
a reaction at a train.
Exactly. And the thing that made me way more mad was Tomo demodded because he was doing the same shit he's been doing for 9 months.
Yeah,
as mod, and he just has had it. Like, I don't know, man. He's saying rebranding, but that's not rebranding. That's called destroying your original community, which was based on banter. But now you can talk shit and you want a yes man chat. That's literally
I even stopped going in offline chat as much because I noticed that like it's different now. There's not
it's
as many
so
spams anymore. I used to love drip drop spam, even though I hated it. I loved it. Drip drop domer walk. Yeah, man, drip drop domer walk.
Oh.
And it's all gone, man. We got Easy Rod. Yo,
what's up, Easy Rod? So
what's up? Work this out.
You got any input on the train sheet?
Not really.
The train stuff, yeah.
Train stuff. That's how me and Cookie met, and me and Ayo.
Yep.
Because I don't really watch train anymore. Because I was a Gordo frog, right? I started watching him during Gordo, and I don't know. I can only watch like his Gordon CS and like South Park. I just can't watch anything else, but his offline community is they're all the boys.
Dude, I usually love... just turn in after the intro. I'll go in for like an hour or two.
Yeah, same. But I loved his. I remember back when I was really in school, really grinding. I would wake up hella early. I would be up at like 7:30 a.m. and I would have an 8 a.m. until 9 a.m. And then from like 9 to like noon, I could just watch Train play CS and open cases. And it was so cozy, dude. With, and you know, Tomo was just doing his thing, and that was my favorite period, man. That was just like, I don't know why people hate on CS. I think it's a timeless game.
It's really cozy.
It's really, really cozy when he's just doing his thing. Even if he, you know, you can, and then you know he could farm little W's because he got carried all the way to MG2, which I have no idea how, but like. CS is just a timeless classic, man. And that was the best time because I don't know, maybe it was he wasn't really looking at chat. No, it was definitely COD, but I don't know, man. He's starting to say the Forjoy stuff seriously. Like he's starting to
on a stack, bro.
He's like starting to say like, "Yo, I peeped this the other day." Like non-jokingly, I'm like, dude, holy shit, you gotta stop.
Have you been watching those bet streams that he does with Andy? It's pretty crazy.
He's about to
go hit a smoke, man. I'll be back.
There's been a lot of gamblers on Twitch lately. I've noticed.
Yeah, and that's also led to a lot of not so good stuff.
I thought you could only gamble on stream for like 30 minutes, but people do it for hours at a time.
I mean, like, if so me being like, there's got to be like age rules or something, right? Like, I just don't see how that's like completely allowed. And then if you saw E-Rob, he got scammed for $500 because basically he was using a website that like in the URL of his like, you know, blackjack lobby, you could type in that URL and somehow get into his account. And then that person used the money. Like the URL was somehow related to the user. And so like he got, I mean, like it's, I don't know. I think it's really risky, but that's a good topic. Yeah. We got to talk about that because
I just think gambling on stream is dumb in the first place.
It gets pretty shameless.
Hold up. Top left, stop talking. Oh, no, no, no. Why did everybody stop talking? Hello?
So, how about this, Corona, huh?
What about it? It's, I don't know, a lot of people have been gambling. Like, I've seen a lot of people on, like, Rubet. And, I don't know, that's not a, you gotta use a VPN to get on there. Like, Knut was on it. He was doing giveaways on it. He was on it for like hours, dude. I'm pretty sure his TOS to be gambling for more than 30 minutes on stream because I was looking into it. Because I was thinking about doing CS gambling. Yeah. I was just looking into it. Hey, but fuck you, dude. Right?
Fucking no snitches, dude.
Hey, no snitching, cut. Yeah, but you can take a small pause and come back, right? Yeah, but it's like 30 minutes per stream. Like, even if you pause and you break, it's still going to do 30 minutes.
Because every, like, E-Rob and, you know, these shameless, what's that guy's name? The Phantom Lord? That's his name. He would do the, like, $10,000 pots and, like, you know, throw his, like, smash his bookshelf afterwards and then get to the top of LSF. It's like, I don't know. I think that must not be very enforced because E-Rob's done 5-hour gambling streams.
But it still is TOS.
Who gambles for 30 minutes, okay?
Okay, if you're gonna gamble, like, go all in.
Addiction, dude. You don't gamble for 30 minutes. And then how are CSGO cases allowed for a certain amount of hours? Isn't that gambling?
Well, because they're like part of the game. It's not focusing your stream on just gambling. You also have the game CS instead of just like you're on a website gambling.
Yeah, I've low-key been addicted to cases recently. It's kind of bad. Ever since I got, I unboxed a pair of gloves that are worth like, so I sold my knife, which was $200. Used like $20 of that for cases, got $300 gloves, stonks. But now I'm addicted to cases, okay? Ever since I got those gloves, dude, I'm low-key addicted, okay?
Hey, I feel good about the next case, dude. Oh, it's bro, just gonna be the that. One.
Literally today, I was like, yo, only five more. And then, like, I was like, yo, I feel the red's coming, dude, I swear.
Nope, it's
but,
not.
Oh, no. Just made fun of Train for that. I didn't make fun of that. Dude, for people don't understand, he's explained it a million times. Think about it. If your entire business and job is to run a stream, you can invest that type of money into your Steam inventory because, you know, like he explained this the other day. He said, well, let's say if I spend $2,000 on a sticker capsule.
True, that's pretty true.
Like, he's going to get subs and donations throughout the entire thing. And then he pays maybe $500, and then he gets $1,000 worth of subs and donations. He's making profit, regardless of what he gets. And then if he gets something that's even worth $500, he's still making money. He knows what he's doing, dude. He knows what he's doing. If you're that high up in Twitch, you know what the fuck you're doing. You're not just buying.
Are you talking about like opening cases?
There's like 2,000.
Speaking of, if anybody gets 500 subs right now, I'll open a case, a singular case.
500?
Only, yeah.
That's a steal.
Yeah.
That is 25 times the viewer count, right? Is my math right?
I don't know.
20 times 25? Yeah, I am right. Damn. Oh. 500.
Wow. Quick math.
Any sounds like 25 timers, Forcing CD?
Okay, what do you feel about, like, a streamer ditching for, like, I don't know, like, 3 months, and then coming back out of nowhere? Like Asmin or, like, Greek?
I just saw someone that did that.
No Sleep TV? He got banned for 3 years.
I don't know. It's kind of like quitting your job and then just, like, coming back to your job randomly, but...
Yeah, but how...
I also think that
if you're like a big streamer, it's like quitting your job. But if you're like a smaller streamer, it's not really like quitting your job. It's like stopping a hobby type deal.
Yeah, but they're like doing it for like mental health issues. Like,
true, man. Yeah, I've been there, like wanting to quit a job or quit something because it's not the best for me.
Nah, but and streaming, dude. Streaming fucks your mental health. I'm gonna be real.
Yeah. I know.
I mean, It fucks with you. I mean, I'm loving every second of it, but you got to think that in the back of your head, like, if you were doing this full-time, sitting at a computer 12 hours a day, your whole life revolves around a number and another number, and...
It's very variable.
It's so... And, you know, you can disappear in a second. How does that not instill some sort of paranoia, some sort of, you know... It's not even the people who are super high up, like XQC, Summit. Like, those people are probably good. Like, they've already been through that. But it's that stage where you're about to make it to a comfortable spot. That's the worst spot. That's got to be, like, the most anxiety-driven fucking grind ever. Like, if you're at, like, 500 subs. If you're at, like, no, not even. 1,000 subs, maybe. I don't know. 1,000 subs, probably. Like... When you start, no, not even. Because once you get to like 5,000 subs, then you're kind of considered like big time, right? Would you agree?
I think there's a lot of streamers who have been on the platform though for a long time. They average 100 viewers and they got like a few hundred subs and they're fine with that and they still stream.
Oh, yeah. No. I'm just saying like, yeah, that's a good point.
Like, people have been on the platform for like 6 years, like a long, long time. Like, Justin TV days,
right? But regardless, I still think it affects you in a certain way. And I think you know, the debate is, would you rather would you rather have a stream every day for 4 hours, or would you have every other day for 8 hours? Now, me and Helios were talking about this earlier, and he said that he would rather have longer streams. I personally would have every day for 4 hours because I'm very I like to move. I like to get up, do different things. I can only do something for so long. I'm not going to watch all 8 hours. I'm going to watch, you know, if it's 4 hours of solid content instead of dragged out 8 hours, I would take 4 hours every day, but, you know, different for everyone.
Yeah, I just...
Yeah, for me, on my stream, I've just been doing... If I'm gaming, I turn on my stream, and then if people are in chat, I'll talk to them. If I don't want to talk to them, I won't talk to them. Like, that's how I do it. Don't really worry about anything.
Why'd you change
Comedy Russell? I just saw that as well, dude.
Yeah, like, I don't know, at least for me, whenever I do, like, a short stream, this, like, 4 hours, it doesn't feel... Like, it's only then that's like, I don't feel like I did, like, a good stream. It doesn't feel like high quality, and doesn't feel as fun or as entertaining, at least to the viewers, than like, 8-hour, 12-hour, even 24-hour stream. I just feel better after doing really long streams. And, like,
well, you are further into it, though. Like, for me, I would say definitely 3 hours. I don't feel good. But for me right now, it's 5 hours. 5 to 7 hours is, like, no, not even. 5 hours. 5 hours, I that's a good stream for me. But, yeah. I mean, today I ended around 3 hours, and I just felt very not good. I felt very empty, although... Fucking Dark Souls, man. I can only do it for so long, dude. I don't know how I'm gonna fucking beat this shitty game.
The game's hard.
The streamer, like Lamont did, you know, don't stop streaming until you beat Madeir.
Yeah, but the thing is he had to take a break, okay? The reason he has so many deaths is because he literally is under level just walking in over and over again reading donos, okay? Like, if he actually thinks about it, takes a break, steps away, then he would have had it done much earlier, I think.
You had some good cheats on Dark Souls, didn't you, though, AO? You had slow-mo active and stuff.
Cheater?
Yeah, he had slow-mo mode that he was using against the bosses and stuff.
RIP.
Any forcing CDers?
Hey, my man. Hey, nothing wrong with a cheater, eh? Did he really? Did he really?
His computer couldn't run it, so the FPS was going down. And it was like slow-mo cheat whenever you do a boss, man. Like, it was good shit.
Was it like really, really? Like really slow? And he couldn't do it.
Sometimes it would just pause.
Slideshow souls. Yeah, I was in there for a little bit, and it was like way too dank, man. It was...
Next frame, please.
you feel, man. He didn't want to talk about that.
Next slide. People pog slideshow.
Well, hey, listen, any gifters? Because, yeah, I was playing Dark Souls in 1280 by 960, and, you know, right around the boss time, it would go into slow motion. You know, I'd have lots of time to prepare my next move. So, listen, any big gifters, I need a PC. My PC is literally like a goddamn oven preheating for a microwave pizza right now. It's fucking disgusting.
Hey, I don't even have a computer. I just have a laptop, so.
True, and she can still play Minecraft.
I built a PC, but it was absolute dog shit. I just wanted to build a PC because I thought it was cool and trendy. So now I have like a laptop that I stream everything from my Wi-Fi and my laptop. So, you know, we're going to get partner with just my laptop. However, well... I mean, hey, boys, I just unboxed some gloves. Anybody want to give me a PC for my gloves?
You stream from Wi-Fi?
Yes, I do.
What's your first problem?
I stream from Wi-Fi as well.
No, that's not the problem. It's my PC overheats. It's really strong.
It is a 24-hour stream.
You can only have so much fans in a laptop. That's literally the problem.
Put some fans on the outside. Keep your room cold.
I mean, I like it nice and toasty. I like to get like a nice butt sweat going for when I'm gaming. That's just me.
Why?
That was a joke.
How do you feel comfortable with the heat?
That was a joke, dude.
Get some swampy going.
Get some.
Oh no!
Some swampy.
He just says swampy. Holy shit!
What the fuck? It's just really hard for me to play like CSGO, like when it's like 100 degrees out. I just can't do it. I can only play CSGO during the winter. That's just me though.
Yo, my house gets cold as fuck during winter, dude. We don't have like,
in New York.
It'll be middle of January. My mom got the thermostat on 56. Like, I'm telling you, I got to have 3 blankets, 4 pairs of pants in order to play Counter-Strike.
That sounds cozy.
Dude. No, it's not cozy.
It's 4 not blankets? All, or 3 blankets, literally, 4 pairs of pants? Dude. That's pretty cozy. I don't have hardwood in this house. It's all carpet. Winter is hell.
Yeah, winter is pretty hell.
Winter is shameless, dude.
Winter is shameless.
So you're in Texas, so it's not like
I love the winter.
I'm in New York, dude. Fucking, it is garbage. No, but it's good because I like skiing. It is cozy inside when it's winter.
And when it's Christmas. Skiing, so.
And also, Christmas, yes. Spam the people happy. Spam the Rock F emotes.
Rock 1F Christmas. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
What the fuck are these winter haters? I hate Texas in summer. It gets so bad.
Is it humid or just dry?
Both.
God, take the fucking wheel.
Both at the same time.
Shameless. Shamelessness.
Shameless.
Yes.
Dude, is that your brother going off?
That's my brother-in-law's brother.
It's always got. There's always the rage in the background. You gotta have the rage in the background.
That makes it. Isn't this cozy? Isn't this cozy, guys?
This is cozy, chat. This is cozy, right?
Pretty cozy, right?
Can we get 100 gifts of subs for this coziness?
Real quick.
Chat. Press 1 if you're cozy. Press 1.
A lot of 2s.
Listen, yeah, there's a lot of chat. Right. Why aren't you cozy?
Violet must not have her pants off. She's not cozy, dude.
Oh, true.
Yo, bring up the clip. Roll the tape.
We have the
what
clip.
Tape? What clip?
We have the evidence. It is admissible in court. Roll the tape.
I did want to talk about winter, though. Like, if you're Canadian, you fucking hate winter, man.
Like,
you
love
go outside.
Winter.
For months, and there's just snow everywhere and shit. And then when it starts melting, shit starts flooding, and there's fucking mud everywhere, and it's all over your shoes, and just like.
Nah, dude, I love winter, and I'm also in Canada.
Fuck.
I love winter too, but it doesn't snow here.
No, I don't do any of that shit. I hate the winter.
Comedy Russell, do you ski?
No, I live in California. There's like no snow unless you go to like the mountains. And it's like. 4-hour drive.
Do you go to the beach a lot?
Nope, far from the beach too.
So where the hell are you?
The valley.
He's in California.
Death Valley?
No, it's like Death Valley. Like,
you guys don't know what Death Valley is?
Of course you know what Death Valley is.
It's in Cali.
Okay, like, I can't hear you.
That's where the Undertaker's from, isn't it?
Oh. Death.
Dude, the Undertaker, Monka W, dude. Dude, wait. Topic. Is it Mike Tyson returning to boxing?
I don't know.
Is that true?
I don't know. I don't pay attention.
I heard him on an ESPN interview, and he was like,
yeah, man, you know, you just don't know because I've been working and, you know, I feel great. I started boxing after 16 years. I started boxing, started hitting them, and I felt great. So, yeah, I felt great. And
he's like, 53 dude, years old. He's like almost as old as Comedy Russell. What the fuck? Oh
my God.
Yo, play the clip. Yo, play the clip.
Hey, yo, play the clip. He's training. Is he gonna like go professional again?
Yeah, I don't
at 53?
Yo, they're making a movie about him pretty soon.
He's coming back. He's on IGF an intro of him training. What the, why? He's old. He's a boomer now.
He could probably still, dude. That guy was unstoppable, man.
Yeah, true.
You ever seen that intro when he walked in when the guy made him recheck his gloves and then he punched a wall? He punched a hole through the wall, and then he walks out, and he has the... you have to look it up, dude. It's this YouTube video of him walking out. I forget the guy's name who he fought. My dad showed me it, but it was like he walks out, and it's just this, like, massive bass in the arena, and it's just, like, sounds of, like, chains hitting each other. And it's him just walking. Like, you know, everybody has like, the robes and stuff. Like, everybody's got the layers. He walks out in a fucking... like self-cut tank top ready to go, and he's just walking out, bro. He like, that is like, there's lots of videos on his on how intimidating his Spinks was. It Spinks, yeah, how intimidating his aura was, because that man, you know, he said when I get in the ring, I don't take my eyes off my opponent. No matter what I'm doing, I don't take my eyes off the opponent. As soon as he looks away, I know I won. That's like not even five head. That's just like next, like not even human shit. That's just like, holy God, man.
Nah, I could probably beat him.
An actual tiger owner? Like, doesn't he actually have a tiger?
Oh, yeah, he does. Yeah, he does.
What, is any tiger owners in the chat?
I could beat him.
I think
tiger owners got a five bomb, a Twitch Prime, you know, what are we doing?
Any throggers?
Spoiler.
Yosha has a lisp. Yep.
True.
A lisp.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Have you seen this, Helios?
Yo, rip Kobe. F's in chat, dude. Yeah. Rip Kobe. I still think about it every day, man. I don't even think it's real. He was my favorite player as a kid.
This is weird. Jay-Z,
like,
my Sammy
legend,
day,
man.
But if I drop
I don't even feel like it's real. I don't. I still don't even know how. Jesus, man. Just crazy. Crazy.
I mean, it's even more sad that his daughter died. I think that was more
true.
Sad because she was so young.
Yeah, she was only
okay, dude. We can't just list all these people, dude. Fuck, man. Now it's just going to get depressing. Yeah, Rip Mac, Rip X, Rip Juice,
Rip P,
Rip Lord Infamous, Rip
Etika.
Rip Etika. Holy shit, yeah. Who else we got? Rip Kenny from Linkin Park.
Ooh.
No. What's his name, Kenny? No. What was his name? Yeah, it is Kenny.
Chester from Linkin
Park.
Chester!
I was thinking Kenny Chesney. Chester.
I think you were thinking of Kenny from South Park.
No, I got the Ches. I just... Oh, God. Yeah, Chester. Chester, Linkin Park. Yeah, I had it. It's fine. Yeah.
Kenny from South Park.
Let's just pull up a list of everyone who's died in the past 10 years and just say Rip. Every single person
in the future.
Who was the singer from Soundgarden that died? Fuck. I gotta look this up.
Grab a Red Bull.
Man, if we're gonna list people that have died, we're gonna be here all day.
Chris Cornell, yeah. Audio Slave and Soundgarden, man. Damn. Rip him too.
Sponsored.
Yeah, sponsored, guys.
Yeah, Chris Cornell died, yeah. He hung himself, 2017, age 52.
He's a good guy.
Yeah, man.
Harambe, the greats.
Man, rip Harambe, actually. That's crazy.
Yeah, my dad was a huge fan of Chris Cornell. So that one, I know that one hurt him because he talked to me about it. Avicii, dude, that one hurt me, man.
That hurt so bad.
So bad, man.
Like, and so young too, still
Avicii's
like
she's dead. What the fuck?
Yeah.
Fuck, dude, I'm living under a fucking rock, man. That's actually fucked.
Was it suicide? I think it was. Rip
Jesus.
Rip was like an overdose.
Rip Lil Peep, man. That guy helped me through some shit. Was it no? What was it? You know what? We don't even need to focus on that, man. I don't want to focus on that, but
Rip Train.
Rip Juice. Yeah, true. Yeah, man. Dude, Avicii, man, I watched the concert like immediately after he died. They had like a tribute concert and they showed like the videos of his life, and it was like a sold out crowd, like 30,000 people all listening to the song, man. Like, it, god damn, he was that one hurts me as well. Him,
shit, I never knew he passed, man. That's crazy.
Yeah, I definitely had like a month after that I heard that happened. Like, I was just listening to his music. I was like getting all the throwback feels from me growing up listening to his music and everything.
Yeah, so did I. It's all we listened to on stream for like a good 2 or 3 weeks.
I think a huge part of it is like Avicii was that those songs that you never knew the name of, but you'd always hear everywhere.
I knew the name though.
Everything. I mean, I knew the name of them, but there were a lot of people I know that like did not know the name. But you just hear him on the radio. You hear him at every school event. You hear him at every family party. Like it. His music was just.
And they were like Nipsey Hussle too. Like
Pop Smoke too.
Oh, Nipsey Hussle too. Yeah. All right, we gotta change the topic, dude. We can go through the list forever, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna get sad.
What's your feel good song?
Like Rip JFK, dude. Like, I mean, at this point, like we gotta move it on here.
We go one by one. What's your feel good song? Like, you listen to the song whenever you wanna, like, be happy, like cheer yourself up. So one song you go to?
I'm gonna open my Spotify.
Yeah, I'm gonna open my.
Yeah, I gotta look at this.
I can just tell you mine. Juicy by Notorious B.I.G.
That's a good one.
A dream. To read Word Up magazine. Yeah, you can say it too. Daft Punk, anything from their old shit. True.
And Zod,
I used to listen to that like grade 7.
I played Centuries by Fall Out Boy on the trumpet. And band freshman year, that quit. Still Dre, good song. True.
Oh, that's a really good one.
Yeah, my man.
I like listening to throwbacks when I'm in a bad mood because that makes me like, I don't know, reminisce, you know?
Ayo, talking about they're releasing them. They only just released like Halo 2 now on the PC.
Yeah, I saw. Like, dude, they got to pick it up here. I remember when I first bought it, I thought that, you know, they advertised it as a fucking 6-game deal. You know, I think even today it's like Combat Evolved, Reach, and 2. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, no, that's fucked. Like,
it's fucked.
I'm not going to play it.
I rather listen to the Ziz Rip Rip Ziz, by the way. We didn't include him.
Just rip everybody, dude.
The Ziz dance.
Rip Johnny Cash.
If I'm ever down, dude, I just start doing the Ziz dance. I start fucking going, dude. That always turns me around. That and like some really hood shit. I don't know, like it doesn't matter what it is. If I just hear some really, really, really hood shit, it just gets me in the right mood.
Don't like.
Chief Keef. Yo, I'm actually a huge... Yeah.
Rip Chief Keef, too.
No, he's not dead. He is not dead.
Yo, rip Donald Duck Big Chuck, too.
True.
Yep, rip us all in the future.
True, just unmod him at this point.
Yeah.
Rip Snow.
Let's just ban him. He's already dead.
Rip Bobby Shmurda? No, he's out. Like... Wait, I thought he was
already
supposed to be out.
Games launch is so bad, they're giving refunds. Wait, I have to do... Rip Snowcash, okay. True.
Speaking about music, like, what's a song that you've... Like, a new song that you've been listening to recently that has...
Bow
like,
with the Bomb.
Bow with the Bomb, the bang, the bang, the...
That's not a new song.
Yeah, but it's a new song that I found recently.
Due to him.
Bow with the Bomb.
What's my Booba? New song?
Okay, dude. A new song, like a song that you've recently discovered, not necessarily new.
Oh, Highwayman by the Highwaymen. PogChampius_7, legend, actually put me onto this song. It's with Willie Nelson, Johnny Cash. It's like not even country. It's just like good music. I don't even know like how to explain it. But this song is so good, man. So good. Such
this
a good song,
right here. I barely found it, but it's like old as dirt. This is a good song.
Is it by Johnny Cash?
Nope. It's by some old dude that probably is a one-hit wonder. I don't know.
Billy Braddock. Heard that name.
Hey, yo. What have you been doing on your stream lately, man? You got your Dark Souls going. Dark Souls. What else are you going to be doing?
Dark Souls, and I'm going to be bringing back CSGO. Shit. I've been playing with Leggy and Envy. And, yeah, man, it's just a timeless game. I don't know. I think I want to find, like, a cozy single-player game. No, that's not fucking cozy. I want to break everything in my room when I'm playing that.
Red Dead 2 is a pretty good game.
Bro, we should hit Portal 2 together.
Yeah. Me and Koke are playing Portal 2 soon. That's
Red Dead 2 is good. Easy, bro.
That's going to be
easy, bro.
It might be a little difficult for my toaster of a laptop, but...
God of War, true.
God of War. Oh, no, I think after Dark Souls, I might do Fury or... What is that other one called? Yeah, Koki and Ao is coming real soon. We're doing Portal 2 together. I want that to be Koki. Okay, want to do that late night?
Yeah, man, anytime.
I want to do that late night. Like, let's say, like, wait, what time? So what time is it for you right now?
Red Dead 2 is free if you have Xbox One Game Pass. That's a fucking steal, bro. Any Xbox One gamers out there? Holy shit.
No.
I might get a game capture and just play some. I kind of want to switch it up and do console games as well.
Yeah, just like splurge your money into an Elgato. Then,
no, my friend actually is giving me a game capture for free because they know I stream and they don't even use it. So they're just going to give it to me. So that's coming soon.
I could do that. I could play like Last of Us.
I have a Switch, so I might do that as well.
Pretty much, I'm just going to borrow my cousin's PS4 for The Last of Us 2, and then that's it. Sold my PS4, sold my Xbox One. Never look back, man. PC gamer for life.
PC Master Race, baby.
Chrissy.
Also,
I like mobile games. Like Marvel Future Fight, that's a really good game. Now's the time to get into it.
Possible sponsor.
Any resident sleepers in the chat?
No, Marvel Future Fight is one of the best games on Twitch. Wait, no, on the phone. No, not lying.
Not a mobile gamer at all.
You can play it on PC too.
PC. Although I am into TikToks. Yeah. That was a joke. Fuck no. Fuck no.
Yo, what's up, Lord Fire Seth? Sorry you weren't able to make it on, man. I was so excited to have you on.
Pepe hands.
Is it Ao? What the fuck did you just say? Oh, yo. You top left. Any Ao subs? Oh, no.
Yeah, who the hell would want to be one of those?
Yeah.
We get some Ao armies in the chat, baby.
Speaking of subs, how do you feel about like an inflated sub count from like a lot of gifted subs?
That's my entire sub count, so I feel fine.
Maybe one of these days. Maybe like next week, Fire Seth.
I was talking about it.
Like personally, so... I think like inflated sub count or not, it doesn't matter because it still shows how much people support you, right, and like how much they like your content. Even if it's just gifted subs, it still supports the homies, still supports the people that can't afford subs, still supports like you financially. It helps you in every single way. So I don't know. Maybe you got 500 subs with around 100 real subs, real. You know, it's just a number, but you know.
Do you think that if you're subscribed to a channel, you're more likely to watch them?
Yeah,
I think that is a correlation because
I think so too.
Because I mean, like, regardless of the emotes, like, I think just being gifted or something, you'll show up, you know, you'll see the notification, and then, like, a lot of the times I feel like you develop a connection. Like, yo, Donnie Dump Truck, literally, just, I'm going to ban you. Just,
yeah.
Just shut up, dude.
Yeah, I feel that, because, like, I use Russell and Train's emotes everywhere, and those are the two people I really watch the most. Like, two big streamers I really watch the most, because, you know, I watch my boys, you know.
Yeah.
Your first gift to a person you didn't follow.
someone gifted, or I did, we did random gifted subs, and fat underscore, no, there was no underscore, it was just fat and black cock with a PH got gifted a sub. And he literally came into chat, and he was like, nice emotes, bro. Thanks for the sub. I was not expecting that. Okay, I thought this was just some alt, some fucking joke, troll account. It was actually named Fat Black Cock with
a
PA.
Are you the anonymous gift? No. Someone gifted
it. No. It was someone gifted it, and it was random, and this guy got one. And he came into chat. Like, I didn't know. I thought it was some fucking bot, dude, with a PH.
What the fuck? What does PH stand for?
PH? No. It's just a way of saying...
Or does it stand for something else?
Oh.
Oh, I know what it stands for.
Oh, we can't say that.
Wait, we really can't?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can.
No,
it's his username.
Don't say it.
It's his username.
Yeah. I was talking about the other thing PH stands for.
Squad PH.
People happy. That's what it stands for.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's something you can say, baby.
That's fat. Save. On a stack.
Save.
On a stack.
On a stack. You want a buck? Let's chalk it.
What the fuck?
Violet, Violet, take it away.
Yeah, Violet. Let's hear it from you.
Wait, what?
Do what you did today.
I did not do a lot today. I was up really late last night, and then I slept a long time, so.
Yeah, you were playing Minecraft, not in voice chat, when everybody else was in voice chat playing Minecraft.
Kind of weird.
Can we talk about that, or what?
Sure. I was very tired, and I didn't want to be, like, super tired and have to, like, talk to people. I was literally just organizing my chests. I literally was, like, passing out, organizing my fucking chest, right? That's it.
Bedtime lullaby? Nah, I'll just fucking organize my chests until I pass out, dude.
Exactly.
I heard you work for, like, a lot of streamers and YouTubers making, like, emotes and stuff.
I heard that, too.
Oh, so I heard that, too. Where did it start?
Well, I started watching this really not very well-known Twitch streamer. I think his name is like Helio something. He was asking for a specific emote, and I was just kind of like, nah, I'm not going to be able to do that. And then I was bored.
He's pretty shameless.
I just was like, you know what, let's just try it. And then I did it, and then from there, it all just spiraled from there.
Spiraled uphill or downhill?
Uphill, definitely uphill. I mean, I got to meet this great community and have a lot of fun making some cool emotes. So
true. Like, Stonecash, you've been ditching just because he's grounded.
Yeah. They're a lot of fun to make, though, and, I like to draw IRL, so.
Yeah, I've seen her work. It's crazy. It took you 6 months to realize the sub icon.
You ever thought about writing an anime with me as the protagonist?
I have not thought about that.
Well, I have, and if you want to, I'll do anything.
Okay, I'll
keep
that
make you a weeb?
Back of my mind.
Yeah, good.
Speaking of people putting emotes that they edit, awesome, how do you feel about that? Like having one of the channel points options to get an emote? that the streamer has without being subbed.
I think, oh, like this?
I think 99% of the time, like, they just fucking, they just like, take it, and then they, like, change the color, or, like, add a, like, sunglasses or something. They always fuck with it. They can't just use it. They can't just have it. Because they know they're just jealous of having a sub, so they're just gonna shit on it because they're not subbed. That's literally it.
I mean, I feel like there's another side to that, too. Like, I, right now, don't have enough money to sub to anybody like myself, and some emotes that I... But I will really watch somebody, and I'll have, like, 50k channel points, but I just won't have enough money to actually, like, pay for a sub to them, and I want to use their emotes still. And, like, in that case, I understand that, like, using the channel points for it.
That's what I've done on my channel. I made it super cheap to unlock an emote. And then, like, if people do want to sub, if they actually want to give me some money, then sure. But I'd rather actually get an actual job than rely on Twitch subscription.
Well, like, I don't know. I don't have it to where you can unlock the emote itself. Because, like, I don't know. The way I saw it when they first came out was that it's like someone can just unlock all my emotes and then not have to be subbed and just be able to use my emotes anywhere. Like, I get both sides, but, like, I'm on the side where I just don't want my emotes as they are being unedited to be able to be redeemed through channel points, because a lot of people in my chat have a lot of points and
true
people that aren't subbed too.
It's shameless.
Who's the first person y'all are gonna see after quarantine?
My grandmother.
A female. I don't know which one, but one of them.
What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drive down to Waco and see my mom and my brother.
I'm probably gonna see all my close friends. Hopefully, I can't wait because I have literally not seen them in forever, and I'm used to hanging out with them like 3 times a week. So it'll be my close friends, definitely.
I mean, I've been breaking quarantine. So
my real answer is gonna be my college friends. They live like 5-6 hours away. They live across the state, but definitely. A bunch of my college friends just got houses right where I'm at, so. Definitely same, just gonna hang with them and just vibe for a
bunch
good
of my
weeks.
Old homies just came back to town, man.
Yeah. Like a lot of people.
This one?
Oh yeah, I just said I've been breaking quarantine, so I've been seeing everybody I wanted to see. So.
I mean, well, good. I haven't been.
I have not been able to see anybody. I have to like be careful because like. My grandma comes over like all the time and she doesn't have a good immune system, so I've been really careful about not being able to leave.
Thought all the old people were like locked down, you know what I mean, like in pens and shit, like they're keeping them away from the young people and their,
what
in fucking fences.
Well, like, you know what I mean, they're like in behind glass or whatever, like
I guess like,
they're in like
we
their
tried
own
to go world. Visit my my grandfather's uncle, and he was like in full quarantine. We couldn't even talk to him, like he was just in behind a glass wall. Just looked at him through the window.
Wait, crazy? That's crazy.
Like, yeah, that's what they're doing in my town. Like,
is that like a nursing home, or is he?
Yeah, a nursing home. Well, at the nursing homes, they
that's
do that.
The thing. Like, oh, okay, the nursing home, yeah. They're locked up.
Not in a nursing home, but she lives on her own, and so it would be like pretty hard for her to like be stuck in quarantine all alone for the entire time. So she comes over to our house a lot, but that just means that I am like fully not allowed to like be around anybody at all.
That's sketchy.
Yeah, I'd say like the safest thing to do is just to chill at home. Like all the people writing about it saying like free
stay
Texas,
in your basement
free New
and stuff, guys.
Cali, stuff like that is really
dumb. It's okay to be a degen, okay? please, if you've ever thought about, you know, maybe if I didn't have so much on my plate, I could become a degenerate and, like, you know, tune into Koki's stream like 24/7. I would just do it. You know, I've been doing it, and honestly, my life has been so much far improved from the good vibes that come from his stream. So if you could just please hit him with a follow, a tier one, a Twitch Prime. Hey, any gifters in this channel as well, hosting the podcast? I mean, at this point, you know, you guys are all
in, sub count,
hey, you know, we know that sub count isn't real. Let's just keep inflating it, you know, fake it till you make it, right?
Let's just keep it going.
That's how this Twitch game is played. So let's just do it.
Yeah, it's not even a real photo of me on the screen. That's just some photo I found on the internet. Obviously.
Typical Squad W.
Violet's a trap, boys. If you didn't.
Yeah. She does have her pants off.
No, I don't.
Pants are off.
They are off.
My pants are off. Ayo's pants are off. Rod's pants are off. And Koki's pants are off.
For the podcast.
I mean, I'm naked right now, so.
I see a sweater.
under the clothes, I'm naked. Pretty much.
Oh, true.
Oh, Violet. The Violet's naked.
Jolies are off. Jolies are off, apparently. Nice.
Naked podcast. All right.
I want to go hunting.
Pants off podcast.
Thing I
want
to do. Do you, who hunts? Koki, do you hunt?
No.
Do you like fish?
Yeah, fishing's pretty cool. I only went with my grandfather, though. Like, I've never went on my own.
My brother's big into fishing, and I just think it's a bunch of sitting around for nothing. I wouldn't go do it unless I could drink a beer during doing it. I don't know.
Yeah, we were doing other shit.
On what fishing you're doing. Like, lure fishing is standing up and, like, casting over and over, which is pretty fun. Compared to, like, bait fishing where you're just sitting down.
Hey, the fishing spot with the boys, though, let me tell you.
Yeah, I used to fish, almost every day with my homies in high school.
Damn right.
All the
damn
time.
Damn right, boys.
Yeah. We had there was a pond. It was, like, in our town. Like, back roads. Yeah. It was back roads as fuck. And we used to go there, like, all the time. And, you know, just keep fishing, dude. We didn't really catch anything, but fun.
Hey, it's done a with good the boys. Time, man.
Hell yeah, man. Okay, high school for me was just, like, every day. Bunch of me and the homies, we'd all go meet up at one buddy's house. Just fucking smoke weed, get drunk and shit. Good times. Get his dad to drive us all home.
Having kids with the boys, man. I miss it.
Even when weed was illegal, people still smoked the fuck out of it. It wasn't even a thing that people wouldn't even care about it, you know?
Yeah, I've barely seen a change since it's been legalized in how many people.
It's just easier to get now.
Yeah, definitely.
We could all do an IRL hunting stream and fishing. Hey, Kona.
Oh,
Helios. You know we're getting a streamer house, okay?
Give it a year,
and we're getting a streamer house in Austin, Texas, and we're getting the best fucking diamond fiber internet with 5,000 up, 16,000 down.
Six consoles,
fucking 18 TVs, gamer chairs lined up. You know, Lee Howe's going to be there. Violet's going to be there. Comedy Russell's going to be there. Rock F's going to be there. We're all going to be fucking playing Valorant, and then we're going to form a pro team and then get a sponsorship and then quit that game because it's dog shit. And then we're going to go play Stardew and hang out.
Well, I don't know about Rock F. Rock F's a... Yeah, no, Rock F. We're gonna fly him out here. We're going to get his visa, and he's going to go from being a poor Brazilian boy to being our rich streamer. Yeah, get Cost in there, too.
It becomes the way she goes, boys. Fucking way she goes.
Get an underage kid and just bring him along.
Yeah. We could also do coke. Oh, like the drink.
Oh. Or like the drug.
Aren't you a Dr. Pepper kind of guy?
Oh, I love Dr. Pepper. I live in Texas. Oh. I can't drink anything but...
Dude, you ever watched XQC's soda tier list?
My doctor.
I almost agree completely with him. Coca-Cola, number one, S tier. Dear God, back in the day, when I was first starting my gamer hours, when I would play Wizard 101, I would play Club Penguin, I would play Toontown, I would play Oh, what else?
312 when you started or streaming?
What?
Club Penguin, Wizard 101. Holy
yeah,
shit.
I streamed Wizard 101.
Hey, okay. All that, dude. All that. And I would drink like five Cokes a night. Like I would sit down at my grandparents' computer because my grandparents always had, you'd go out to the garage fridge and they'd have just Coca-Cola, Barks, Dr. Pepper all lined up.
Dr. Pepper.
And you like, and it's just unlimited, right? But you got to grab like three in one go. Yeah. You don't want to be seen walking out to the garage five times. So you got to grab like three for the road. You're going up, you know, my grandma's giving me like a bunch of Lay's chips. I'm fucking yoink. I'm just going, right? And I would sit there, bro, and drink like five Cokes a night. Like just like grinding.
How many cavities do you have?
I have zero. I have zero. I have never had any.
I used to be addicted to Pepsi. I drink probably from the age of 14 to like 18. I drank a 2 liter a day.
Holy.
And that's not a cap. I'm not even capping right now, boys. So I actually stopped drinking pop. I haven't drank
2 liter a day?
Any pop at all in like a year now. I only drink energy drinks every once in a while. A little bit of coffee. That's about it.
That's good.
No more pop for me.
Yeah, I mean,
I stopped.
I don't like. Okay, like the only time I'll have pop very rarely, but I just generally don't like a lot of the pop, so I don't know. I drink it very rarely. If I drink it, I like root beer. I know that's gonna be kind of unpopular,
root
but
beer.
Yo, Easy Rod, thank you for the follow, brother. Appreciate it. Hey, you gotta respect the co-host. You know, Helios always gets all the clout. Hey, just kidding. Any gifters in Helios's channel? He deserves it, dude. He's putting on a goddamn show. Are you not entertained? Listen, I know you got $25 laying around. Just drop a five bomb. Are you kidding me? What are you doing at this point?
$5.
Okay. I mean, what are you doing? You got 25. Listen, you're sitting here on Corona vacation and you're just sitting there doing nothing. And I know you got $25. Listen, you go watch a movie. You got to bring a date. You get popcorn. It's $18. You got to go get Coca-Cola. It's fucking this yay high, right? It's fucking $18. You spend it that much. You ended up spending $45, right? So why not, instead of watching a movie, you're watching us, and you can chat in live time, talk shit about us. So why not drop a five bomb? That's all I'm going to say. Carry on.
So there was a time, like, my sophomore year, like, 4 years ago, I had surgery on my jaw, right? And what my dad told me was that I couldn't drink any soda because it would fuck up my jaw. And I did not drink any soda at all for like a year, and then I don't know, I drank a Dr. Pepper and it made me feel sick. Like I didn't drink soda for like 2 whole years, and
holy fuck,
I don't know, I was healthy. That's when I was working out, right? When I was big. I was drinking. I felt really healthy. But, you know, then I started drinking Dr. Pepper.
Just weird vibes, dude.
I just really love Dr. Pepper.
My Dr. Pepper, you don't
understand. Speaking of, that is a sub notification. It's surgery on your arm in like
any subbers?
No. No one subs to me.
True. I'm not even subbed to you.
Speaking of subs, Violet, would you ever start streaming? Or Easy Run, if you get a webcam, Violet.
Wait, Helios, why are you doing this? She'll immediately have more subs than all of us combined. Why the fuck are you doing
True.
That?
I can leech off her.
Why the fuck are you doing that?
Paying for a free podcast? Yeah, kind of weird.
True's my man.
True.
Speaking of
White Heart 07, dude.
White Heart 07. My man,
White
any
Heart
free 07. Subs? Violet stream? Exactly. I would instantly gift Violet 200 subs. Actually, maybe
I
more.
Don't doubt it for literally a second. Literally a second.
I'd be able to do it on the 15th if she gets affiliate by then. If they're 200 subs.
MacBook Air stream, dude. That shit would be hotter than the fucking sun. Oh
exactly.
My god.
Exactly
oh
what?
My god.
Violet stream out. Okay.
Okay, dude. Fuck out
of here. Spanish.
This is odd.
Did even Nightbot happen? Look at this.
I mean, I would definitely consider streaming. I just don't have the resources to do it at the moment, and I wouldn't want to do it half-assed if I were to do it. So,
like my streams.
Hey, I thought I. That's I what my I had stream is. So like it's fun. Listen, yeah, no, I, dude.
But I have like a quarter of the resources that all of you guys have. Like, I don't even have a fucking desk. Okay.
From your bed.
You got a box. I
play with you guys in my fucking bed.
Pants off, stream MacBook Air on a laptop, no face cam. Let's go.
Hookie does have a 3 monitors.
Built-in laptop mic, no graphics card. Let's go.
I actually have a baller setup. Like, I'm not trying to think.
Don't you have like 4 monitors? 3?
I got
4?
3, yeah.
Holy shit.
If we get to
once I get a PC, I'll take my hands off. Get a PC, I'll have a dual monitor and a laptop. Like for like data storage. So that's literally next. First off, I want to get a new mic.
I'm going to get another PC.
Helios, can you link me whatever mic you have, dude?
It's like $400.
Holy fuck.
Okay, I should give for the...
That's why I got the Walmart mic, man. Because I'm going to break it one day, and I just don't want to break $100. Like, fuck, eh?
Nah, my mic just has, like, a lot of background noise. It's a shitty snowball, dude. It's just, like, you know. So, I want to get, like, one of those radio ones that you got to, like... You know, the streamers always are like sitting here, right? They're starting stream. They're starting stream, and then they gotta fucking pull it from like deep, like fucking all the way. They gotta pull it up here. They got a pop filter covering half their face, which you know would be great for me. You know, once it's big acne season, just have a pop filter covering your entire face. And then you just like talk like this. You're just like, yo, boys, how you doing? It goes right into their fucking down
like
into their eardrum.
And like, Leafy, dude.
Ew, yeah, Leafy literally deep throats the fucking.
Oh, for sorry. Hey, we gotta make do what we got, eh? I'll just do this.
No, it's gonna be some way too dang noises soon.
Fuck. Okay, there we go. Jeez. I have my pop filter. Is it good?
Oh god.
Just like Leafy did on YouTube. Gotta cover my chin, right?
Where is Leafy at now, dude? Where the fuck?
I heard he was making
at?
A comeback. I mean, like a. 2 second video, so I don't know.
Protect it from
a 2 second video.
I don't even know. Let me look.
Dude, I could sneeze and miss his video. Like, why the fuck? What?
I got a question for y'all.
Do you have
masks that are handy that you can put on at any time?
No, I have bandanas. Time? Hold up, I'll go get mine.
I haven't been wearing a mask. I don't go outside.
I don't go outside, so.
I had another one. Go. In your car? Oh. You don't wear a mask when you go out? Me neither.
I actually do go out to smoke, though.
But you don't see anybody, so.
Bandana face mask?
I don't have a photo of myself with a bandana face mask, dude.
Is that a pop? Oh, ooh, I don't have to pay for one. Also have a landmass that is equivalent. What? You don't go outside?
Oh,
me neither.
Oh, he's talking about Canada being huge.
Oh. Just us, Violet.
Uh-oh.
And it's canceled. Oh, speaking of season, did you see that the NBA might return in, like, weeks? I don't care, because I don't watch, yeah, sports. But did you see that?
I don't watch sports.
Yeah, I don't keep up with that sort of stuff besides like football, barely.
I heard about hockey though.
Get those Canadians in here.
Any Canadian frogs? I don't.
Yeah, we got Cokie, we got me, we got young old Joy.
UFC being on has been very awesome. UFC's been on. I start smoking again. Don't do it, slushy. Basketball's the only thing you semi keep up with. Well, you're also like 6'3 and have a perfect build for basketball. Your volleyball season beat down? Is that what you're talking about? Who watches hockey? There's like one hockey team in Texas. you just quit smoking, that's good.
Saturdays are for the boys. My man.
Saturdays are for the boys. Wait, why did he pull that out?
That's his face mask, obviously.
He wears that out every single time he goes out.
Yeah, You gotta have the boys. You gotta have the boys sign.
True, true. Five in.
You gotta be reffing.
Hey, reffing the gang, hey.
It's not gonna protect him very much, but it's definitely gonna
help. Yeah, I couldn't breathe under there. But yeah, this is my certified corona free absolute baller mask. But yeah, I had this flag before it became cringe. Before when it was actually like Barstool was low key and it was like 3 years ago. Let's go. I actually won this on a free giveaway, and then I've always had it. So
free?
Dude, you want the receipts, Violet? God damn it.
Well, if he got it for free, he wouldn't have a receipt, right?
True.
No, I've had a receipt on how it was shipped to my house.
You mean like the box?
I didn't pay anything for it.
A shipping receipt?
I don't know. I just said receipt. I'm generalizing. Fucking hell. It's fucking 1 a.m. You think I got time to be specific? No.
Yes.
Triggered AO.
Top left.
You got that yesterday? Dude, I don't even think they sell these anymore.
Saturdays are for the boys. Like, of course, it would sell.
Saturdays are for the boys. Shit, in 2020, no one.
Me. I'm gonna buy one. I'm gonna put it.
Like, yeah, and you'll probably sell it as your merch.
Yeah.
No.
I don't have the sweater on anymore. That's right. It changed. That's the widest thing I've ever. Okay.
Yeah, you should make. OD face masks, obviously.
I could do that.
Wait, yo, make merch face masks. Corona season, take advantage.
Yeah, make OD face masks and shameless face masks.
Shameless face masks. If I did it like a month ago, when I made the other stuff, my pirate now. Arr.
Oh no.
It's a flex.
Captain Jack.
I can't see out of my right eye.
Can you ever?
No, I'm actually blind in my right eye. You know that?
Yeah.
You know that?
Yeah. Well,
how?
I don't know. Something.
He stalks me, chat. Donald looks weird. Yeah, I know he does.
True.
You know, I took a little break, right? I'm coming back and I'm thinking, you know, I think we gotta find out more about Violet because, you know, she's laid low under the radar. And, you know, that's a smart move considering she's gonna start streaming soon. You know, you better tune in. You'll be running out off her goddamn 400 degree toaster on her lap with no pants on. But you better be there because it's gonna be crazy.
Please mention the no pants.
So if you have a tier one, a Twitch Prime, I mean, might as well just save it at this point. So, anyways.
Save
we find out more about you. I mean, why should people sub to you?
What? Why should people sub? We're not gonna do this right now.
Okay. Well, I just want to. What are you about?
What am I about? No. Why don't we
Who
save? I'm gonna save this for my own content. I can't be giving Shameless. Away my content. On-
Shameless. I need the content. Shameless. Your Violet mod? Okay, Sam. Nobody's allowed to see that. Oh. Okay, she's a simp for you, Violet? Is that true?
I don't know, man.
What? Sarkash? You good, man? Good?
What did you say?
What? Sarkash is a simp?
Has a hard-on for Donald Duck? Dude, why are you Monka W? And I'd be in that ass like petroleum jelly. Like, you ever get a big ass rash in your ass crack and you gotta put fucking Vaseline in there? I mean, I've been there.
That's pretty true.
Yep. Koki gets it, dude.
He's underage!
I said I'm calling Chris Hansen.
Alright.
Hansen's had a comeback on YouTube.
True. You're the king, you say.
No, I'm saying if a guy admit no, don't do that. I'm saying if a guy admitted to liking me, I don't know his age, dude. It's fucking yo. Relax, dude. Relax. I'm saying in general, I would be in that ass. Not your ass. I'm just saying, in general, if I had to,
I think you're just digging yourself a deeper hole there, bud.
Yeah, just, well, let's move on.
Yeah, I'm just a Valorant streamer. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Yep. Speaking of Valorant, it's a lot of bigger streamers have stopped streaming it.
Yeah, I haven't heard a lot about it.
Good thing or bad thing? Good thing. Valorant sucks. Who are these Johnnies? What do you mean?
Who the fuck are you, Drew?
Yo, Drew, cam up, dude. Cam up, dude.
I swear to God, bro.
Cam up.
Okay, so weren't you going to cam up? Anybody have any input on Valorant? Not as how it was when it first...
How many viewers is it at now?
Probably still a lot. Dude, but Anomaly dropped from like 80,000 to 30,000.
Well, yeah, because they were all fucking bots. And because, any Mr. Destructoids in chat?
Yeah, me. Smile.
Because they were literally... I mean, he was up to like... Wasn't he up to like... I don't even know how many, dude. He was up to like numbers that the top streamers on Twitch don't even get. So, yikes. Yikes.
But like...
It was like confirmed that he had bots.
Well, of course, his streams are like 24/7 streams.
Kind of weird, dude. Bots. Yeah.
80k all day, every day? Yeah, I know. And then when Twitch crashed, he dropped to like 5k. Then he went back up to 80k. And now he stopped doing the 36-hour streams and he's only at like 20k. So, you know. Mystery fuck AO8.
I think Valorant will probably come back once it comes out of like what's called beta or whatever.
Yeah. On release, you know. It'll come back for a little bit. But, I mean, it's not going to... reach out was when people were trying to get jobs because it's been like a month and a half of it being out, right? So, you know, everyone's already getting drops. So, you know.
When do the drops stop working?
Probably when it gets released, right? I think
no,
so.
No, it still works, right? It still works right now.
It's not released. Yeah. Like,
imagine not having a drop. Yo, Bobs, FaZe Bobs, I know you're in chat. Does Danny still not have a drop? That man has been watching like 200 hours of Valorant and he still doesn't have one. And I got one and I don't even watch it.
I got one the first day from Moxie. Holy shit. Literally the first day.
I
got
one and I didn't know I had one for like 2 weeks. I just didn't know. I thought.
Oh, he finally got one? All right, fair enough. Who the fuck doesn't have one at this point that's trying to get one? If you're trying to get one and you don't have one, that's just rough, dude. That's rough. He played like 2 hours and got bored. Yeah, he went back to Minecraft PvP. Okay, not surprised.
Did you try to get a drop, Drew? Like, I played it once, like, 2 games, and then I haven't played it since. And I got a drop the first day. Minecraft, oh. Yeah, I don't know.
Good game.
True.
Yo, we do need to find... Hey, boys, listen, in chat, if you guys you guys are gamers, right? What would be a cozy single player wholesome game?
God of War.
No, that's not wholesome. That's murdering tons of people.
Red Dead Redemption 2.
Okay, Rudolph Omegalol. Listen, I'm trying to start a conversation here. What's a cozy Wizard fucking 101. Wholesome game? You pieces of shit.
Wizard 101,
dude. I'm not playing that again. Jesus Christ. Dark Souls. Yeah, listen. You watch my Dark Souls stream and you tell me if that's cozy. It's not. Okay.
The Escapist right is now. Pretty cozy.
It is cozy, but it's not. It is, but it's not at the same time.
The Escapist?
Stardew? Yeah, we played Stardew. The Escapist.
Have you played Detroit?
Well, me and Koki are going to play Portal. So I guess we have that. But
RuneScape.
Big collab for 80 million people, dude. It's going to be crazy.
Farming Simulator.
Sold out. Yo, wait. There's a game called Farm Together. We should try that, dude.
Farm Together
looks actually pretty decent. It's like Stardew, but I think it's first person, is it? Or it's like third person? It's not like top down. It's like let me look it up.
The Forest is a good game too. You can play Jump King.
I also kind of want to play what's that horror game where like one person is the the horror game where one person is the murderer and you have to try
Dead
and escape.
By Daylight?
Yeah. Have you played that?
No.
Do you play that? No. I've heard really good things about that.
I've never played it. You can play Ark. That's a good game too.
Ark, dude. What is it? 2016? I'm not playing Ark, dude.
It's 2020.
Exactly. So I'm not playing Ark.
Like
Farm Earth. Together. 9 out of 10 on Steam, bro.
You can go to the restroom. No, you're not. DB Dead by Daylight is pretty nice. Yeah. I actually had a lot of streamer friends that played it. Like Wavy Sinatra, he plays it. Fuck this top. Ark is good. I played Ark with some of my IRL friend, well, one of my IRL friends, like for like 300 hours, like for like 9 months we played. That's crazy, dude. It's actually so fun. And we had this mod where our characters were naked. I never streamed it. Yeah, naked character. Especially, I got into Ark when I stopped streaming in 2018, and then. When I quit Ark, is when I started streaming again, actually. Maybe play Dead by Daylight on stream once. I might try to get into it, but, like, I don't know.
Did you guys ever play Slenderman back in the day?
Like, on the iPad?
Oh my god, I remember that.
On the iPad? I mean, I remember there were, like, knockoffs, but, like, on the PC, did you ever have, like, Slenderman.exe?
Dude, no.
Those were the days, man. Those were the fucking days.
Boy, he's just storming outside. Yeah. I'm gonna die.
It wasn't even really scary, though. I mean, I played through Outlast, and that was 10 times scarier.
I can't play through Outlast. I cannot.
Yeah, I did it, and it was pretty bad.
That was on a Mac, yeah.
What was the scare counter, Bobs? I think we were at 80 or something throughout the whole game. What was it? I think it was 80. Yikes, dude. It was bad. It was real bad.
Pumpkin!
I got tired of my face.
Oh. I didn't.
Yikes.
That was kind of cringy, dude.
Please.
I would almost recommend adding Pain's Champ for that comment right
there. I gotta send y'all a picture. Rate Odin. Rate that picture of Odin right now. If you say the wrong answer, you're getting kicked. Rate it.
I'm a cat guy, so I like cats more.
What would you rate that picture of Odin, though?
Let me see it.
Oh my god, he's like curling up right underneath. Don't sit on my power cords! No, I sent it in a Zoom chat.
Yeah, but I have to copy and paste it into fucking Chrome.
Odin's so scared right now, dude. He's sitting on my power cord, though. So, you know, mock a W. Oh, damn.
Yikes.
He hates storms. His name's Odin, and he hates storms.
Oh, that's a good, that's
now,
a good boy.
Now rate the picture.
Wait. Compare rate it to something, or just
no,
rate it?
Just rate it.
11.
Oh, 10 out of 10.
Thank you. Good answer.
100 out of 10. 100 out of 10.
Good answer.
Yeah.
I'll give it an 8.
Are you showing it on stream? Show it on stream.
Did you say an 8?
Let the people vote. Yeah, an 8. Let the people vote. Play Fortnite solos. It's wholesome. I'd literally rather slit my wrists. Fuck no.
Calm down with that.
I'm not playing that dog shit game, dude. The sound engineering was designed by a fucking 5-year-old, dude. That was too far. I would say... I'd rather...
Oh, dude, you're on my mouse!
Play Dark Souls for 8 hours a day than play Fortnite solos. Which I do. So.
6 out of 420? Really? Only? Dogs. Odin.
What's that percentage? What's that to a percent?
13.
Odin,
why are you so scared, buddy? No. He actually really, really hates storms. Give Odin a hug real quick. Okay, bye, chat.
It's actually 16.
Yeah, 16.43.
Yep. So you better try that again, Helios. Hey, no streamer, White Hardo. Any gifters? Now that the streamer's finally gone, maybe for the other content on stream, like the beautiful, the man, the myth, the legend, Easy Rod, he's a special guest. Why don't you give some subs here?
I mean, I'm not even sub myself right now.
That is just shameless. That is shameless promotion. That is
shameless.
I'm just a nice picture of Violet's nose, everybody.
Koki's nose. No, by which she's in a sweater. Are your subs are?
Oh, sweaters.
All my subs are about to disappear soon.
Subs. Season Star Cash?
Snow Violet.
Snowit. Wait. That's dumb.
That didn't work.
Okay, dude.
I just got a gift sub to Pokimane.
By who? Was it by UNF?
Oh, man. I fucking need that.
Easy Rod, UNF, UNF 920.
It was probably by corrections.
CJ underscore M underscore 60.
UNF. Okay, Rod. Oh, Pokemon is live. No. Okay. Do you follow Pokemon, live? Easy Rod? I'm
out of here. Why is she live so late? 1:23 a.m.? Oh, birthday countdown. Wait, she's been live...
Yo, what's up, UNF? He has Pokemon's emotes, but not mine. Okay, dude. That dude is so weird. Corrections?
Was corrections.
You need Pokemon? No.
Yo, let's get corrections on the podcast, dude. We gotta figure out who the fuck that is, dude. We gotta figure out who this guy is, dude.
No.
This guy spams PokeW in every single chat. Single chat. I just see him. Spamming Pokey W.
Comedy Russell on the podcast. What do you guys say?
He literally uses his chat for content.
So he told me. I talked to him about it, and he said that he just doesn't want to do podcasts anymore. Like, he used to do them all the time, but he just said that he got tired of them and he didn't want to do them.
He's too big now.
Yes.
1K okay. Andy, relax, buddy.
His own emotes.
Nah, remember Russell actually followed me, and we like talk shit all the time. It's great.
Okay.
He's never gonna help me do anything. He just wanted to take my emote and then follow me and then never talk to me again.
That's Russell.
Yeah. Nope. He's ditching
shameless.
You.
Shameless.
Oh, Young Violet. Yeah, I already have him muted. I really just can't hear him right now. I can't hear anything he says.
Yo, Donnie didn't believe it. He literally went into my chat to do followage on me.
Yo, young, old
shameless.
Joey, thank you for 300. Thank you for the 300, brother.
Any Ducky fucking gifters, dude? My boy needs a fucking...
My boy needs a new Bentley truck. You feel me?
Yeah, sure. I'll get a new truck. New truck. You know who I would love to get on the podcast? Who I would love to get on the podcast?
Pokemon?
Darion.
Yo, true. Yeah, that's holy crazy. Shit. I don't even know.
He reads every single message I put in his chat. It's so weird. Koki, you were there once, right? He fucking reads everything I say.
Isn't he like a 70 viewer Andy, though?
Yeah. It's like 420 subs right now.
Damn, that's so...
Hey.
My man.
He lives with Ms. Kiff. That's crazy, dude. But it's because he was college friends with Lamont. Did you see that?
Any JCG fans? Straygasm?
You can hear the thunder.
Hey, that's my cue. I'm out, boy.
Why?
All seriousness, I'm out though. I'm gonna go play some Minecraft and then I think I'm gonna do GTA. On
Yo, Koki, you're not going anywhere, okay, bud?
What the fuck?
You're not going anywhere.
We've been here for 2 hours, motherfucker.
We can't have you leaving, Koki.
2 hours? You're not leaving. We're going 4 hours, bud.
We're going 4 hours.
You better strap in. You better strap in.
I'm sitting here just, I'm baked, man. It's the only thing to say.
When are you not baked?
Isn't that just the standard at this point?
Yeah.
What, 24 hour podcast? No, I was just telling you I had 2 hours and then raiding Koki. What?
Yo, Koki, tomorrow, guys. 30 more minutes. 30 more minutes.
Alright, I'll just sit here.
30 more minutes. Let Koki do what he wants. I know. What?
I mean, Koki,
we love you, dude.
Ducky, shut up.
We love how you just come in when it's necessary.
Get some love on the cock.
Okay, on a stag, bro.
You know what? I don't.
On a stag.
Get some love on this.
On a buck, bro. On a buck, chalk it. You know what I'm saying? You
chalk it up on a buck.
9 inch. Oh.
Hey, Jolie. Do the command. I need to know.
You know what? On a stack, I'm not. Dude, I'm sucking a tree on a stack, bro.
Bugging, dude.
That's all the topics me and AO had. AO, any topics?
Nice.
I think I have more. No, we had more. What are you talking about?
Didn't.
What do you think about famous people going on Cameo?
Do the command, Jolie, do the command. Cameo's dumb.
You think they should just go to Twitch instead?
Yeah. Cam Gross just moved to Twitch. Famous people.
What do you think about this influx of porn stars and cam models in going on Twitch?
True.
Like me and my co.
You wanna know why?
Only accept one. Why? It's the same thing.
Look at, hey, they figure out what live stream fails is. They go to live stream fails. They find out nip slips, hot girls, all this, blah 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 blah. It's popular. Well. Let's pretend I'm Amanda Cerny, who's a million follower Andy on Instagram and Vine, blah, 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 Vine, TikTok, everything. Did you see that clip of her literally begging for subs? She's like, you know, if we don't get to like 5,000 subs, like there's just no point. There's just no point in like having a schedule. Like, come on, guys. Like,
it's just $5 though.
I don't know, dude. I don't know, man. Yeah, it is only $5, but dude, she started literally this is 3 days in, and she's asking for 5,000 subs. Like, shameless.
I mean, she's an ego, right? So she's automatically gonna be a 5K sub Andy, right? Right. She started a few days before that clip.
She's already partner, I bet. Fucking. I don't even
Project Melody isn't partner.
I don't even have to look. She's probably a partner. I don't even give a fuck, dude.
Project Melody isn't partner yet. She's been streaming for like 3 months now.
Because at the end of the day, it's always just about money. Because if Twitch can make money with their partners, they see this girl, Project Melody. She was, you know, top of LSF. She was getting on podcasts. She was, you know, subs flying left and right. She's getting bitch cheers more than she can even say, right?
True.
She's got to update her anime avatar outfit before she can even continue talking about her bit donations.
Man, so, I don't even know how that's done. What is that? It's like a robot or some shit, or
dude,
like
I don't even know, man. I don't even know.
I thought it was like VR chat or something.
Yeah, I think it's like VR. It's something with VR. Like she puts the headset. I don't know.
It's like a full body tracker.
Go to 500 subs and she'll keep streaming. Yo, if we get to 500 subs, I'll keep streaming. Your subs are sunk cash right now. Down.
How many are you at?
Like 300. Yeah, 294.
Any 200 gifters?
Okay, dude.
Where you at?
Wes BTW? He isn't partnered. And he's a 300 viewer Andy. With like, I think it's 1K. 1K subs. He's not partnered.
Wes, by the way, ain't partnered?
Yeah. I thought he was, but he's not. He's still affiliate. Fiend.
No way.
What? Sub Fiend? Is that what this is?
Sub Fiend?
Wait, so what happened to the Oiler that was going to be on the podcast tonight?
Lord Firestuff? He just said he'll probably be in bed.
No. What?
He just said he'll probably be in bed. They said it was 10:30. It's adjust with his schedule. So, you know.
So, if he's in bed at 10:30, it's probably his mom's credit card, right?
No.
Or he has a job, maybe?
He designs houses. What? He just said he needs to come on. He needs to fix his work schedule and his sleep schedule. RSF does construction? Not really. He just designs houses.
So he like makes the blueprints or what?
Yeah. No, he just designs it, like interior design and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I know some people like that. They actually make a living, man. It's good money. It's good money in that shit.
That's 400 gifted.
That's the job that nobody thinks of. That's the job that nobody thinks of, man. Like the house design and I'm working on building a garage for my mom's boyfriend's beach house right now. So that's why I'm looking like Rudolph right now with this red ass nose. But I'm out there in the sun. I'm out in there in the sun 9 hours a day, Saturday and Sunday. So that's why I haven't been streaming those days. But yeah, there's these people behind the scenes that got the bulldozers. They got the fucking, they got the, you know, just logs of wood at their house. Like, I don't know where they get this from, but they come prepared. So they're like the, you know, they're very important to the operation. So yeah. But he makes good money. He said, his dad, this kid that's running like the op, I mean, he's not running the operation, but he's doing like all the bulldozing and like the concrete floors and stuff. And his dad retired at age 39 because he was in house development management. Like,
holy shit.
Imagine retiring at age 39, dude. Like, I fucking wish, dude. Holy shit. That man probably had money.
Right now, honestly.
Yeah, so, and by the way, hey, any subs, any Helios or my or Kogi subs automatically get free entrance into my beach house, by the way. So, yo.
Oh, I'm a Helios sub.
Pog boys, we're going to have big ragers going down at my beach house. Any subs here, there, or near. It's gonna be a big event. So please listen. You gotta sub to all of them. Sub to all of them. You get the VIP room.
He's so shady.
We're not even gonna talk about what goes on in the VIP room.
Hey, you're so shameless. Oh my god.
Oh, I love it. Oh, it's so fun. It's so fun.
I just looked at Russell's chat on Chatterino at 09. Now hosting Mischief, and then 8 minutes later. Now hosting Pokimane. Oh no, Russell the same.
Oh no.
Yeah, AO will sponsor the flight to the beach house.
Yes, I will. Yes,
no wonder he's drinking. What the fuck?
Perfect.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright.
Shit, I'm gonna go pack my bags for that Rager though, guys. Seriously.
Yeah, me too.
For real. Any gifters?
What? Yeah, he went to go do his stream.
I think it's time.
I think it's time to wrap up the podcast.
I'll probably be playing Minecraft for a bit, so if anybody
I'll play
wants
Minecraft
to
play with you.
I don't know, I'm probably just gonna be mining diamonds. I'll be on the Casa server.
I'm not on Casa server.
You don't have a whitelist?
No. Yeah, easy run.
He should be up soon.
Okay. Just mining diamonds, that's what I like to do.
So first, if you guys I'm the co-host of this podcast, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so anyways, listen, follow all the channels. At least follow them. You know, if you're thinking more than that, just why not gift us a sub or something like that. But however, big cast tonight. I really love this podcast. It was just good vibes. We were talking about everything and anything. I think these podcasts where we don't have a guest prepared and it's kind of more grassroots, I think I like those more. I don't know why. I just think it's very, you know, authentic. It's very original. I think we all have kind of very different aspects of life that can all provide to the general conversation. So great podcast. I appreciate every single one of these people in chat, every single person, you know, on the podcast, especially. Be sure to shout them all out. And yeah, Violet will be on the Raj show real soon. So be sure to tune into that. And then she's going to stream with her hot ass toaster laptop with no pants on. So you got it. You can't miss it. You can't miss it. That's all I'm going to say.
Thank you for having me, Nico. I had a lot of fun.
It was fun having you on.
Yeah, hopefully I can come on again sometime. I was a little bit nervous at the start, especially because I don't have a lot of knowledge on some of the topics you guys talk about. But once we got a little bit out of, I mean, obviously this is Twitch and it's video games and And so a lot of the content has to be based on that. But once we got a bit out of it, I was able to contribute more, and I thought that was fun. I mean, it was good to, like, learn more of, like, what you guys have to say. So, yeah, I had a lot of fun. It was a good podcast.
Yeah, good podcast, boys.
Yo, chat, press one if AO Aiden should be VIP in Helios's chat. Press one.
Press one if I should kick AO Aiden right now.
You, what? Two, one.
Everyone's saying,
you know what? I don't know.
Everyone's saying
that's
one.
Two. I don't know what. Okay. I don't know what. Okay.
Everyone's saying I should kick you.
I'm just going to see myself out.
All right. See you, AO.
Good stream, boys. Yeah, good stream. Love you guys. Love you guys.
Oh, it's just me and you.
I can't. Hold on. Wait, am I out? Am I out?
Yeah, I kicked you out.
Okay. Oh, no. Oh, lovely. That really, I'm half chubbed now. All right, seriously, bye.
See ya.
I disconnected him. Ooh.
Yep. All right. Well, that was a good podcast. Hopefully, I can come on again.
Yeah.
I got one of my homies in the chat today to have a good watch. Shout out to. To my boy Jolie.
Oh, that was one of your homies?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, shoot. That's what's up. Oh, you. One in chat to kick Violet.
No.
What?
There's only one. See how there's only one and it's you, Ducky? Shut the fuck up. Shut okay. The fuck up. Get out of here.
Are you going to stay in VC?
Yeah, maybe. I might get off for a bit to grab something to eat, but then... I'll be back.
Okay, I'm going dark. I'm deafening so that I could do the outro.
All right.
Jeez, boys. That was, actually... Dude. Because I'm thinking... I'm taking a break from Twitch. Just to get my mind off stuff. But... What if I just did the podcast? Like, once a week... Be light. Just do the podcast. Because I'm taking a mental break. Because I need it. And, yeah. I'm just not in the right mindset to be doing regular streams. But, like, the podcast is just really fun. I just really enjoy it. It's like what Gordo was. It's just my favorite stream every week, man. And take a break. Then, yeah, I'm taking a break. But, like, I just really like the podcast. So, podcast is actually lit, though. Yeah. We're gonna... Yeah, I'll do the podcast every week, though. If you want to stay in contact with me, hit on my Discord, hit on my Twitter, hit on my Snapchat. Discord. Hey. Twitter. Go follow me on Twitter. Go follow my Instagram. I don't use it. Snap. Yeah. You have me on Snapchat too. I'll add you back. Thanks for chilling, boys. Thanks for keeping chat wild. Thank you so much. We're gonna play the outro.